How do user accounts get hacked? How do hackers steal millions of customer emails, usernames, and passwords? SQL injections. That's how. What's an SQL injection? Is your website at risk, and how can you prevent it? An SQL injection is a type of attack that hackers use to gain access to databases and steal information. An SQL injection cracks databases by manipulating the system's SQL requests. SQL requests and commands are the language that a website uses behind the scenes when you need to access information from a database. If a site hasn't been properly secured, a hacker can trick a website into creating SQL strings that contain the hacker's commands. By injecting their own SQL commands, they can impersonate a user account or completely take over a database or server. Here's an example. A hacker wants to steal customer usernames and passwords from an online store. If it isn't secured properly, the hacker could abuse the site's functions, like search. They could then type in arbitrary commands combined within the resulting SQL string. There are different SQL injection types that make the database do different things. The most common are in-band SQLi, out-of-band SQLi, and inferential SQLi. An in-band SQLi attack uses the same channel to launch an attack and to extract the results. So, if a hacker performs an attack manually using a web browser, the result of the attack will be displayed in the same web browser, the out-of-band SQLi. This is when a hacker adds subqueries to the user's main query. The subqueries can force a database to return extra information. In an inferential SQLi attack, also known as blind SQLi, the hacker can't actually see the response of injected queries, but they can observe the application's behavior and modify its structure. So now we've talked about the three main SQLi attacks. You're probably thinking, okay, so what exactly can hackers steal from me? Well, I've got two words for you. Anything and everything. If you were hit with a nasty SQLi attack, a hacker could steal almost anything in a database. That means customer emails, usernames, passwords, addresses, phone numbers, photos, you name it. But that's enough of the scare tactics. Let's move on to the important part. How on earth do you prevent this stuff from happening? Tip one, don't keep all your data in one place. Keep customer credentials in a separate encrypted database to general product data, and you'll be able to keep damage to a minimum. Tip 2. Program your site to use pre-made SQL templates with fixed values and a question mark where the keyword would normally appear. With a prepared statement, a hacker won't be able to add new commands to the string. Tip 3. Build input validation, also known as sanitization, into the backend of your website. That way, you can create a whitelist of accepted search terms. So when a hacker searches for a malicious command, the system won't run the code and will just return a no results message. There you have it. Three essential ways to stop SQL injection attacks. Show this to your boss, show this to your friends, use this for your own website or company, whatever you do. Don't underestimate the power of caution, because once you've lost your customers' data, you also lose their trust. And well, we can't help you much after that. So, subscribe to stay cyber aware. It's a jungle out there.